Let's begin with the connections now. So when we try to connect the various members in the steel structure, that is beam, column, similarly tension or compression members. So when we try to connect these members, so we use some sort of connection. So these connection can be made using rivets or bolts, or we can use welding also. So these are the methods, the way using which we connect these members. So this is one sort of classification depending upon the method of fastening. Apart from that, there is one more classification, that is connection rigidity. So we can say that either the connection is rigid, or it is a simple connection, or it is a semi-rigid connection. So what does this mean? A rigid connection means that whatever is the moment capacity of these individual members, the moment capacity of the connection is also the same. So in this case, for example, the moment capacity of this connection is same as the moment capacity of members. So here we say that this angle which is there between the two members, it will remain intact even after the application of load and no rotation takes place. And the second one is simple connection. So in this case, we say that the moment capacity of the connection is zero, and I mean we do not consider this joint to carry any moment, and it acts as a hinge. We consider it to be a hinge, so it cannot carry any moment. And the third one is semi-rigid connection. So that is, it will carry some moment and some rotation is also there. So in actual conditions, the every connection would behave in this way, that is it will carry some moment and some rotation. But depending upon the fact that if the moment carried is more than the rotation, then we can classify it as a rigid connection, or if the rotation is more than the moment, then we can say it is a simple connection. So we normally try to divide it into rigid or simple connection to make our design simple. So for the simplicity, we do this kind of classification. Now let's see little bit about rivets. So rivets are metal pieces, that is we form a rivet head on this, then we heat this rivet, and then we can insert it for the joint. So whatever kind of joint we want to make, lap joint, butt joint, so we will insert this rivet here and then we will hammer it. So this dia will be less than the dia of the rivet hole. So initially this rivet hole dia is more, but when we hammer it, so expansion of this metal will take place, or this rivet will expand and it will completely fill this hole dia. So it is, the design part is similar to bolts, and in IS 800 not much is talked about these rivets. Most of the design is considered using the bolts, but for the working stress method, we'll cover the design of rivets also, or how we design using rivets. And one more thing is that some disadvantages are there in this rivet, such as noise pollution will be more, and you need skilled labor here to fit these rivets. Apart from that, its labor cost is high. Or if we talk about, if we want to repair them, so repairing cost is also high, or repairing is difficult. So these are the issues with rivets. In the design, in the bolts, normally we consider the nominal dia of the bolt, that is the dia of this part, it is called shank. So in the Both design we'll consider the dia of the shank, whereas in the rivet design we can consider the dia of this rivet hole, because when we hammer it, due to the expansion, the dia of this rivet increases to the dia of rivet hole. That is about rivets. So here now we'll start with the bolts, and later we'll see the welding also. And in bolt, when I'll solve some questions, then I'll take some questions from working stress to cover the rivet parts. So the bolt so for a typical bolt, let me draw a rough sketch here. So this is the bolt, and this part would be the thread, and this part is the shank, and this we call the bolt head. So when we go for the design, so for this thread dia, or it is called the root of the bolt, we take the area as ANV is equal to 0.78 times pi by 4 into d square, and pi by 4 d square is the area of this shank, and the dia of this shank we call it as the nominal dia. So that is the basic terminology here. And after that, the classification is there. So bolts can be of three types, that is unfinished bolt, unfinished or black bolt we call it, and after that there is finished bolt, finished or turned bolt, and the next one is HSFG bolt, or it is called as high strength. High strength friction grip bolt. So in the name itself, here it is written that it is an unfinished bolt. So it will have square or hexagonal head, and we are talking about the unfinished bolt. And for this area, shank area, it is not finished properly. So it will be rough. So the contact area, that is between, let's say if we are trying to connect these plates, so the contact area, here we put our bolt. So because this surface is rough, then because of that, the contact between this plate and the bolt is not proper. So we use it for making temporary connections, or if we are trying to erect some lightweight structure, so for that we can use it. So the bolts which are used in this case, that is unfinished bolt, these are made of mild steel. And about the class of the bolt, so these bolt are designated as M16, M20, M24. So what does this mean? So that is the shank dia here would be 16, 20 or 24 mm. And if it is a class, so class are defined as 4.6, 4.8, like that. So what means this 4.6 with here is 400 newton per mm square would be its ultimate strength, and 400 into 0.6, this would be its yield strength. That is, if it is a 4.6 class bolt, then the 400 newton per mm square is its ultimate strength, and 400 into 0.6, that is 240 newton per mm square, is its yield strength. That is how the classes are defined in bolts. After that, there is finished or turned bolt, as we call it. So in this case we finish this surface properly. That is, it will be smooth in this case, so the connection or the contact area, contact between, if we are connecting plate, so in that case plate and bolt would be proper. And the in this case what happens here is, so this bolt hole dia, it will be relatively big if we compare it with the turn bolt. So in this case we only give the allowance of 0.15 to 0.5 mm. So this bolt dia what we are going to make in the plate, this is just 0.5 mm to 0.5 mm bigger than the bolt dia. And apart from that, so this connection would be better than the last one, and it would be tight, and the bearing contact is more because it is, this surface is smooth. And after that there is one more type of bolt, that is high strength friction grip bolt. So it is made up of medium carbon steel. The last two are made of low carbon steel, that is mild steel. And in this case the normal class, the class is also high, that is 8.8 and to 10.9. this is the class for this bolt. So here you can see that ultimate strength would be 800 newton per mm square, something like this. So in this case the bolt transfer the forces or this connection between the plates or whatever the member we are connecting, this force is transmitted using the friction, whereas in the other two cases it is transferred using the bearing. So how it transfer, or let's talk about this friction and bearing, that is one more criteria for the classification of bolts. Classification of bolts, so we can classify them as friction bolt or bearing bolt. Friction bolt and bearing bolt. So friction bolt means, as we were talking about this high strength friction grip bolt, here this connection is very proper. So these bolts are stressed up to a very high stress, that is its proof stress. We call it as proof stress, and that proof stress is equal to 0.7 times the ultimate stress. So the grip between these two plates would be more, and if the force is applied something like this, so the friction bit which is developed between the plates, it will be much more. And so here the bearing and shearing action of the bolt does not come into picture. So that is about the friction bolt. Now for understanding bearing bolt, let's understand what is this bearing action and the shearing action. So if it is our connection, and here we have inserted a bolt, so if the load or the force is acting in such something like this, then how this bolt resists this load? Due to this surface which is there of between the two plates, there will be shear stress, and due to this surface, that is this vertical surface here and this vertical surface here, there will be bearing stress. So these are the two actions using which this bearing bolt transfer the stresses. So actual stress diagram would be something like this, that is the stresses will be more at the edges or at the surface, and it will be less near the center. But in reality we consider the stresses as uniform for our design purpose, so that we'll see in the design. So after that we'll start with the codal provisions and then we'll solve the questions on the boards.